Hello and welcome. In this problem, we're trying to solve for x, and we've got these fractional powers. Give it a shot, try it out, and then press play when you're ready to solve it with me. All right, so I notice all the terms have x to some power, right? X to the negative 1/2, x to the 1/2, and x to the 3/2. So when I started solving this problem, I tried to look for just things I could factor out. I tried different things, and one of the things I tried that worked nicely was x to the negative 1/2. Factored this out. And why would I even try that? Well, I have the negative 1/2 power here, and I know that it gives me 1 when I factor it out. That seems useful to me. Also, I notice that it becomes minus 2x to the first, because here I can tell this is going to be true. What I figured out was, okay, well, I'm factoring out x to the negative 1/2, and the negative 1/2 power, if I multiply it by the first power, remember you add powers when you multiply. In this case, you're going to subtract 1/2 from 1 because it's negative 1/2. And 1 minus 1/2 is 1/2. All right, so I'm getting this exponent here. I'm not losing that. So then here, I have to think, okay, well, x, so here is the 3/2 power. So when I factor out negative 1/2, right, I have to multiply it back and still get the same power, 3/2. So when I multiply the negative 1/2, it's like losing a 1/2 in your power. So I want it to be 4/2 or 2. And all I'm saying here is this works out because x to the negative 1/2 times x squared. Well, if you take 1/2 away from 2, you are left with 1.5, which is 3/2. Now this is really nice because in this term right here, x to the negative 1/2 means 1 over x to the 1/2. Negative powers, right? We're dividing, essentially. And if we're dividing by, this means 1 over the square root of x, this means that x cannot equal 0. Because if x is 0, it's undefined. So now we know that it's an important thing to think about in this problem. X cannot equal 0. And then here, in this part, we're going to reverse things around. So we get x squared minus 2x plus 1. And that factors out nicely because we have x minus 1 squared, right? That's the factored form of it. And when does this equal 0? Well, if we square root both sides, we get x minus 1 equals 0. And then if we add 1 to both sides, we get x equals 1. And that's the other solution that works here. All right, so we have an undefined result where x is 0 and a solution when x is 1. And we want to isolate both of those. Thank you.